Hello everyone, my name is Vishaka. I'm a first year BDA student from Savita Dental College, Chennai, and I'd like to present my poster on the topic Mulla's method of age determination using mandibular left third molar. As we all know, development of dentition can be used in determination of age in situations such as attainment of maturity, marriage, consent, criminal responsibility, employment, etc. So basically, we know teeth are non-destructible and have the least turnover of their structure. So they provide a vital clue in identification of individuals in forensic odontology. So therefore, a system of dental age assessment using radiological appearances of maxillary and mandibular teeth was devised by Mulla. This method is basically a classification of dental age development. It has stages from 0 to 10, which represent the events in the dentition development of children. So Mulla basically divided the calcification of permanent dentition into stages such as stage 0, absence of crypt, stage 1, presence of crypt, 2, initial calcification, 3, one-third of the crown formed, 4, two-thirds of the crown formed, 5, crown almost complete, 6, crown completed, 7, one-third of the root formed, 8, two-thirds of the root formed, 9, root is complete but the apex is open, and the final stage, 10th stage, root is completed with the apex closed. So these were the stages given by Mulla. And as we all know, it is very essential that any dentist who's treating children, that particular dentist should have a good knowledge about the dentition development. Firstly, because to, you know, widen one's own knowledge about the developing dental problems and also to improve one's clinical judgment. And it has been pointed out by various investigators and a lot of literature that dentition development has a strong correlation or strong association with other methods of growth too. Now, we know there are like other methods of identifying chronological age too. Like you can look at the length of the long bones or you can look at the fusion of the epiphyseal plates. But why they are not so reliable is because length of the long bones, it is only applicable until the bone stops growing. And in case of females, it is around 16 to 17 years of age. The tibia stops growing after that. And in case of males, it is 18 to 19 years of age. So like, according to me, teeth provide a very reliable and they provide a reliable and accurate indicators of age assessment. So for my study, 50 OPGs, orthopantomographs from the Department of Oral and Maxillofacial Radiology from Savita Dental College were selected. Out of those 50 OPGs, 25 belong to male and 25 belong to female. And the age group that I took in consideration for my study was 10 to 15 years of age. And for my study, the development of mandibular left third molar was chosen for dental age assessment. So as we all know, most of the teeth are undergoing development and calcification simultaneously. But from the early teens, most of the other teeth have erupted and calcified except for the third molars. So therefore, like by choosing the third molars, the third molars make a very good option for dental age assessment from late teens to early 20s. And also the other teeth, they might have undergone some restoration procedures, which would make it difficult for us to assess their development. While the third molars would not have undergone restoration procedures. And we also know by assessing the differences in the developmental stages of third molar in a particular population, you're calling for more ethnic specific reports to be developed, to be performed and developed in other parts of the world. And so these are the reasons why I chose the third molar especially. And the reason for the mandibular teeth is because mandibular teeth, as we all know, mandibular teeth erupt before the maxillary teeth. So therefore, I chose the mandibular left third molar for my age assessment. So like after considering all these points, I was able to find out a comparison between the chronological age of the individuals and the third molar development. So basically each OPG was taken and the third molar was compared with the dental stages, with the developmental stages, 3-8 staging given by Mulla. After that, all the recording, all the information was recorded into Excel and then transported to SPSS, statistical process for social sciences. There, both descriptive and inferential statistics were run through. In inferential statistics, I performed the chi-square test. So like basically, I was able to find out the mean and the standard deviation values for know the actual age and the 3-8 staging for all the OPGs, for all the 50 OPGs, which I've provided in the poster. And I was able to do the chi-square test for two parameters. One is gender with actual age, and the other is gender with 3-8 staging. Now, gender with actual age, I did not find any significance. Maybe it is because my sample size was very controlled. Like, I had only 50 OPGs, and I had divided it into equal sample distribution, like equal number of males in the age group 10 to 10.9, equal number of females, like the same number of females in the age group 10 to 10.9. So basically, I did not find a difference in the gender and actual age, but I was able to find a significant difference in gender and 3-8 staging. So basically, I found the p-value is 0.02, which is less than 0.05, shows high significance. It basically means there is a difference between the 3-8 staging of males and females. So for example, if I've given the 3-8 staging is nothing but the staging given by, provided in the NOLA table for the third mandibular third molar. So for a 12-year-old boy, if I've given the 3-8 staging as 7, for a 12-year-old girl, it would be 6 or 9. So like there is a difference between the 3-8 staging. I was able to identify that in my study. And then one more reason to choose this age group of 10 to 15 was because NOLA's method is more applicable in a younger age group and say dental age estimation using NOLA's method is very helpful. And then I'd like to discuss some of the other literature studies done by other people. So like a study done by Bolinos et al. In 2000, he said that NOLA has provided stages for calcification of individual tooth. Therefore, it proves to be more accurate and reliable, thus making it most commonly used method around the world. So basically, since NOLA's method is easy, inexpensive, and very less time-consuming, it is more better than other methods like Demogen's and Williams method. And also because NOLA's staging is very precise, he's given a lot of stages. So that is one of the advantages. And the other thing is a study conducted by Noor et al. In northeastern Turkish population in 2012. So basically, the study was to assess the validity of Demogen and NOLA's method, like which one's better. And in that study, NOLA's method was found to be more accurate and Demogen's method proved to show some kind of underestimation in age. So that is another study. And then a lot of studies have been conducted relating to NOLA's method all around the world, in England, in Bangladesh, in Turkey, Malaysia. So like to conclude, estimation of age is basically the most important aspect of forensic research. So this method can be used for the treatment of orthodontic, pedodontic patients. Then it can be used in cases of mass disasters and natural calamities where not a lot of remnants of the body will be there. So basically, using this method, you'll be able to identify the age at death of the individual in these disasters. And then in cases, and forensic odontology has been increasingly used in both civil and criminal affairs. Like it can be used to identify if a person has to be prosecuted as a juvenile or as an adult. Then it can be used in situations where the birth date is not available, as in case of illegal immigrants. Then it can also be used if any problems are there in managing employment issues. So yeah, I'd like to conclude.